Here is mine from age 57, 58, and 59. As I said a few minutes ago, I expected to do a victory lap because of my work and on my lifestyle and prevention, but I didn't know either at the time to be focused so much on insulin resistance, prediabetes, especially in somebody as thin and that works out like I did. Didn't expect it. So instead of having 50-year-old arteries like I expected, I had 73-year-old arteries. Was not a happy time, but I made a few adjustments. And if you're a statin hater, close your ears. One of them was starting a statin. Have been, still am a statin hater. But at the end of the day, if you have plaque, it is a good idea. If you're 50 or 60 year old and you have an LDL of 130 and you don't have any plaque whatsoever, I'm not convinced that you need a statin. Even with all those other numbers, even at age 63, even with an LDL that high, because you've demonstrated that you've never really burned the lining of your artery wall. So you've never really had that LDL deposit in that intima-media space. So I did that. I lost 10 pounds. I was like 170 when this started, and that's too heavy for me. And as I continued to look through this, I found that yes, even though I was 57, even though I still, you know, major runner, major endurance athlete, did the other kind of stuff, watched my diet, still had plaque, and I had significant insulin resistance. Since then, I've actually recorded a couple of blood sugars over 200 for me. So you could technically say I have full-blown diabetes, but again, enough about me. This is helping you understand what resulted over the next 18 months. Despite thinking I had none of those problems, I started focusing, went low carb, added the statin. I lost about 10 pounds from 160. Actually, it was mid 160s, between 165 and 170, then lost 10 pounds to 155, 160. All those things over the next 18 months resulted in a decrease in my arterial age from age 73 to 52. I'm 63 now, and my arterial age is still in the low 50s. So I'd like to talk with you a minute about the webinar. People don't understand what the webinar is. It's actually a great way to get some access to healthcare that you're just not going to get any other way. You actually get the lab tests yourself at a local lab, a Quest lab near you, for the inflammation panel and the OGTT and the insulin survey. These are things, inflammation and prediabetes, that your doctor just does not know about. And here's the thing. Harvard Health and many others have said, look, sudden death is not always so sudden. The Hollywood picture that it's a bolt out of the blue is not realistic. It's more like real lightning preceded by clouds, wind, and rain. Stop that metabolic storm before the lightning strikes. And here's where that metabolic storm comes from. It's inflammation, and it has to do usually with prediabetes. So again, we actually get labs, we go over them in the webinar, and then you can start finding out how you can prevent that heart attack others said that you couldn't even predict. We can show you how. Thanks.